Hello, my internet friends, and welcome to another video. Today we are going to review the house of Maison Margiela. They're a very popular niche brand, and so I got my hands on a couple of their fragrances, full size and samples, and I wanted to do a review. So are you ready? So I have two samples here which I've tried extensively, and I also have five full size bottles here, so we have a lot to play around with. Let's start with my least favorite. This is Flower Market. This has notes of freesia green leaves, jasmine sandbach, Egyptian sandbach, tuberose, rose de mai, and peach, oak moss, and cedar. When I spray this, all I smell is flowers, like a bad blend of flowers. And the flowers don't even smell fresh. The flowers smell like they are gone bad. Or it smells like a flower market that's not a pure flower market. It smells like a flower market that is just a flower market on one side, but they're on the other side of the market, they sell fish and meat. And you can smell that pungent. You know how meat can smell bad? You can smell that pungent smell of meat coming through, but then that meat, that smell is masked by overwhelming amount of flowers on the other side of the market, which is the flower market. So it just smells like when your house, your apartment smells bad, and instead of going to the source of the problem or the source of the smell, you spray a really cheap air freshener on it. This is what it smells like, just a bad blend of flowers that's supposed to mask something. It's just really strong, it's just really nauseating. I just don't know how this made it through like all the various stages of perfume making and then made it onto the market. This is horrible. It makes me nauseous. I wouldn't recommend it to anyone. Before I go on, I want to say I got this Volt as a Volt set. So it was a little bit cheaper than buying these individually. Individually, these will cost you about $130 per bottle for an eau de toilette. Let me go with my next least favorite, which is this one, Under the Lemon Tree. This just smells like what it says, Under the Lemon Tree. It smells like back in the day, Shakespeare was trying to write a play or something, and he had writer's block, and he went to sit under the lemon tree to, you know, for inspiration, to, you know, to stir up his creative juices. And this just smells like Under the Lemon Tree. Nothing more, nothing less. It just smells fresh and lemony. And I use the word fresh very lightly. It just smells citrusy. And I think I just associate citrus with fresh. I'm saying fresh. But that's it's just a bit. When I spray it, I just get a burst of citrus. Nothing more, nothing less. And this has notes of lime, petitgrain, cardamom, green tea, coriander, and white musk, cedar, and rosehip. So that's all I get. Just the citrus. Maybe a little bit of the green tea, but it's nothing. $130 for an eau de toilette that doesn't even smell that great, and these don't even last 2-3 hours tops. Okay, so I wouldn't recommend that either. Next on the bottom of the list is Coffee Break. This apparently has notes of coffee, none which my nose can detect. I do not smell any coffee. It does smell like a nice break, like you're having a really hard time or stressful time and you decided to take a break. This smells like that nice breath of fresh air. You decided to take a break and, you know, went out together. It just smells like a nice breath of fresh air. It's a very simple fragrance in the listed notes. It has lavender, apparently it has coffee, it has so it's floral, it's a little creamy and powdery, it's a little bit spicy. You know, it's not as simple and as bad as these two, but nothing to spend. Again, nothing to spend $130 on an eau de toilette that you'd need to keep spraying to smell like it. And why would you even want to smell like this? I do not know. So these are my top four, and I say top four very loosely because they are the remaining four. So by default they are top four, but I wouldn't call these top anything. Surprisingly, I'd put Beach Walk in number four. I say surprisingly because I'd smelt 1, 2, 3 as well as Sailing Day in Sephora, and my top two were Beach Walk and Jazz Club, and I was saving up to buy Beach Walk. The thing is, I smelled them during quarantine, and you can only smell them on the piece of paper, and the piece of paper can be very deceptive. When I smelled this on the piece of paper, I actually really liked it. I was looking forward to this being my spring and summer fragrance. It's what it says it is, a beach walk. That's what it reminded me of when I smelled it on the paper. It's very fresh, very happy, very floral, refreshing. It turned musky, it turned powdery on me, and I just really liked, when I smelled this in the store, it was everything a beach, you would want a beach walk to be. It was sweet, it was floral, it was just light and airy. I could smell some coconut in there, I could smell some citrus in there. It was vanilla, it was powdery, it was tropical, it was creamy. It was everything I thought I wanted on the paper. I never got to spray this on me because it was COVID. Now this has notes of lemon, pink pepper, bergamot, ylang ylang, coconut milk, heliotrope, musk, benzoin, and cedar. My skin, it turns very mature. It just smells really much 45 flat in my opinion. It doesn't smell like a young carefree person walking on the beach, you know, like this picture they have here. I don't know if you can see this picture of this young lady topless. It doesn't give me that feeling of this topless. It doesn't give me this vibes. It just gives me a picture of a more mature person in a very conservative one-piece suit walking on the beach with a significant other. They've been together 10 plus years. It doesn't give me this vibes of this young girl topless. You know, you can see her hand going back like she's holding her significant other and they're just having fun on the beach. That's not the vibes this gives me, okay? It certainly doesn't give me this vibe, and it's just a little bit mature. It doesn't last, so when I spray a couple of sprays, like 4 or 5 sprays, it smells okay, but then you can barely smell it. It doesn't last. And why use a perfume if you can't smell it and it will last? So you try to go in with more, and the more you spray, the more I spray it, it becomes very nauseating to me. And if I don't use a lot of smells, I cannot smell it. So it's almost like, what's your purpose in my life? You know what I mean? So number 3 is this one by the fireplace. Yeah, I went to Sephora. This was the reason I went. Actually, I'd heard so much about By the Fireplace on the internet. I wanted to test it for myself before buying it. And this was the day I went to buy this. But when it was sprayed on the paper, it just smelled so horrible. All I could smell was smoke. And so I didn't buy this. Instead, I bought Jazz Club. I ended up returning it because I didn't open it before I got this. This says male and everything I've showed you so far says female fragrance. This is male and female fragrance, and this is a perfect example of don't spray it on the paper because you will not get a good sense of what this is compared to what you get on the paper. This is actually quite nice. This on the paper, all I was getting was smoke, but on my skin it's smoke, but the smoke goes away pretty quickly. You can smell the smoke in the background, but it's a more comforting type of smoke, like it says By the Fireplace. It's more comforting and it's just creamy, powdery on my skin. I can get a little bit of soapy feeling. I don't know where that comes from, but on my skin I get a little bit of soapy feeling. And so all these feelings I didn't get from the sheets of paper. So if you want to sample it, the sheets of paper is not a good way to go. But on my skin, I could get the smoke, but even the smoke turned almost woody, almost earthy. And I like that. I like that in a fragrance. I like that earthy quality. Like I said, it turned powdery or musky. It's very spicy, obviously. And you can get hints of vanilla. So for me, that's a good fragrance. It has notes of cloves, pink pepper, orange blossom, chestnut, wood, juniper, vanilla, Peru balsam, and cashmere. So that's by the Fireplace. This is one of the more long-lasting fragrances from the line. It's one of the beast mode fragrances from the line. It's more projecting, it's stronger. Even that, I give it 3-4 hours max. They need to spray, you need to respray or reapply. And to me, that just doesn't make sense for a fragrance. I know it's an eau de toilette, but then so is Hypnotic Poison, okay? So I just don't get it. There's so much hype around this fragrance, and I just don't get it. Yes, it smells nice, but it almost has a soapy fragrance to it. It's almost soapy. So it's creamy, it's powdery, it's vanilla, it's woody and all that. And it's just nothing to write home about. It's not a terrible fragrance. You know, you won't smell bad. This is terrible. Okay. Flower Market is terrible. This is not one of the terrible ones. But again, it's just, at this rate, to go to the drugstore. You know, if you just want something to smell nice, then there's no need to spend $130 on it. There's so many things that will make you smell nice. Number two is Jazz Club. Now this I knew I liked, even on the tester strip I liked it, and on my skin I liked it even more. Okay, this is very well done, very reminiscent of a Jazz Club. You get the rum in there. It's sweet, it's vanilla, it's a little bit woodsy. I get a little bit of smoke, not as much as by the fireplace, but I don't know if it has, I get a little bit of smokiness in here, very little though. It's very spicy, turns powdery on my skin. It has notes of pink pepper, neroli, lemon, rum, sage, vetiver oil, tobacco leaf, and this is very nice. This is male fragrance, so I do admit it has that cologne feel, but I don't think it's male fragrance by any means. I think definitely very unisex. I don't think it's a male fragrance. If I would say this is more masculine than this, in my opinion, this is stronger and deeper. I really like Jazz Club. As to whether or not I would spend $130 on it, it's another question, but I do kind of like Jazz Club. And then my favorites from this very bad purchase I made, it's Lazy Sunday Morning. The best done in my opinion is Lazy Sunday Morning. If you take a look at this picture, the girl sleeping on a Sunday morning, just carefree, naked, just in clean sheets, white. That's what I get when I open this fragrance. I get that feeling of those commercials where they're advertising relaxation. You know those fragrances where they're advertising relaxation? Could be a hotel, a particular state, and the girl is in bed, then someone opens the curtains and then the sunlight shines on her, and then she wakes up with a smile, she stretches, all is well, they serve her breakfast in bed, you open the curtain, she goes on the walk, on the beach, and the wind blows her scarf away, just that whole feeling. And I think this is done very well. It's powdery, it's floral, it's very fresh, it's sweet, it has a little bit of soapy quality to it. It has notes of lily of the valley, pear, rose, iris, orange blossom, white musk, a whole lot of musk stuff, and Indonesian patchouli leaf. I think this is the best done fragrance in this whole vault I got. This is definitely my favorite. If I had to recommend two, and that's really with, if there was a gun held to my head and I had to recommend two, it would be Lazy Sunday Morning and Jazz Club. This could take you all year round, because this you would use for your warmer, for your warmer months, and this you would use for your colder months, and those would be your signature fragrances. I guess the burning question on everybody's mind is, are these worth it? I have this philosophy that nothing we buy in this world is worth it. Everything is highly overpriced. It's all about making profits and all that. So nothing we buy in this world is worth it. It's all up to you. What does it mean to you? How much are you willing to spend on it? What feeling does it invoke in you? And how much is that feeling worth to you? How much do you want to spend on it? Someone who wastes money, I buy things that are not worth it. But would I spend $130 on these? No, absolutely not. No, never. I would never spend $130 each on these. They don't last. You would have to... I go through a 3.4-ounce bottle of fragrance. It takes me about 3 years. And I'm an oversprayer. This I could probably go through in a year. So do I recommend them? Absolutely not. There's too many good fragrances in this world for you to be going around smelling like you're sitting under the lemon tree or smelling like this flower market. Apart from this, which I really think is bad, I don't think the others are bad. They're just not me. Like I said before, I like my fragrances to go forth before me, and these are not it. I try to sell these on my Poshmark. I have my Poshmark listed below. I can sell these individually or as a set. I'll put my Poshmark down below if anyone is interested. I'm really tempted to keep Lazy Sunday Morning and Jazz. Now, Lazy Sunday Morning and Jazz Club, like I said, are good fragrances. At this point, you may be wondering, if they are good, why are you trying to get rid of them? I'm getting rid of them because I'm just thinking into my collection and how carefully curated it is. Things are absolutely lovely, epic fragrances, epic to me. I'm thinking, when will I ever in my life reach for any of these over my other fragrances? And the answer is never, absolutely never. So there's no point for me to have these. If anyone is interested in any of these, please let me know. Thank you so much for watching my video today. This is me blowing you a kiss. I hope you enjoyed this so much enough to maybe subscribe, like, share, leave me a comment down below. Let me know what you think about these replica fragrances. And I hope I see you in my next video. Bye and stay safe. Bye-bye.